I'm Daniel Taylor. As newly minted professionals in business, healthcare, education, and most any industry leave school and work within their professions, it can be difficult to remain current with the most recent innovations in their fields. Seldom used tasks tend to eventually be forgotten as well. Thus, it is essential for most professions to have some form of continuing education available. And in fact, this is often mandated by some governmental authority. Yet, merely having such a framework present does not suffice, as the quality of available continuing education must be of a high level as well. Additionally, there is a need for such programs to be efficiently produced and presented, so that they remain financially stable. In fact, many for-profit continuing education providers exist, whose very existence as an industry and as individual entities is based upon producing education that is both of high quality and cost-efficient. Thus, instructional designers should be familiar with the best practices of professional continuing education to assure such an outcome. Professional continuing higher education is defined by Cantor as that lifelong learning function that organizes and supports courses and programs beyond a traditional and formal degree program. Many people have taken on the task of defining how such education should best be developed. In this vein, the Council of the Continuing Education Unit released their Principles of Good Practice in Continuing Education in 1984 as a reference for designers, consumers, and sponsors of continuing education. Though too numerous to list here, the Council's recommendations can be summarized using a four-stage approach, in which learner needs are determined, learning outcomes are set based upon these needs, learning experiences are developed to meet those outcomes, and, after the instruction is given, the outcomes are assessed as to how well they had been met. All of this is based around and informed by the administration that is creating the instruction and its mission. Emphasis is put on active learning techniques, content that is designed to teach material that will be of practical use outside of the learning environment, and streamlining of content around the learner's needs and the outcomes that are based upon them. Though this early organization is useful, much has changed in the last 30 years, and so new guidelines are useful when updating continuing education for internet-based education. There is high demand for continuing education that will not require long trips to a central location, but can be taken in the comfort of one's own home over the computer. When developing such courses, effort should be expended on making the user interface dependable, easy to use, streamlined, and efficient. Technical bugs in the software will lead to reduced usage very quickly, and should be prevented or at least quickly eliminated. Content must be stellar, and production of learning objects of a high quality. It should be easy for a user to find the course he desires in the course catalog. The process of registering for the continuing education should be simple to complete. For the sake of potential future use, some notification system should be implemented that provides information about course offerings to the professionals that are in the database. Efficient evaluative, certification, and assessment elements must be developed as well. It is clear that online continuing education is an involved process that requires great attention to design. High-quality professional continuing education is essential for the maintenance of knowledge and skill. Design professionals should strive to supply high-quality experiences for their consumers, both to improve the financial impact of continuing education and the level of content mastery.
My heart, now and forever, and our love had its start not long ago. We were gathering stars while a million guitars played our love.